إن الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. حديث 257 part 2. The hadith says, برسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا معاذ أوصيك, I will give you advice. لا تتعنى دبر كل صلاة أن تقول. Don't miss after every صلاة to say, اللهم أعني على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. So he was talking about the biography of Mu'adh bin Jabal. And we mentioned his life. He was 20 years old when immigration of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. At the age of 21, he took part of Qazwatul Badr and he died at the age of 18 Hijri in Sham, in Hims. Al-Ahadith al-Warid fi fadlihi, the hadiths which has been mentioned for his virtue. Awalan, mutafiqun alayhi, an masruqin, masruq tabi'i, qala, dhukira Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. There has been mentioned the name of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, the great companion, and Abdullah ibn Amr, at the place of Abdullah ibn Amr. Abdullah ibn Amr was sitting in there, and they mentioned Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. So Abdullah ibn Amr wants to teach the companions. فقال ذاك Abdullah ibn Mas'ud is رجل لا زال أحبه. He's a man, still I love him. Why he love him? He's the same tribe, he's the same nationality, he's not neighbors. Why he love him? Because of the iman. To love the person because of the iman, that's the iman. And to hate a person because of the iman, that's iman. But he doesn't give you wealth. You hate him, that's not Islam. You hate him according to his position in the Islam. So he said, I love that man, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Why? سمعت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول خذوا القرآن من أربعة. Take the Quran from four companions. A lot of companions were hafiz, but these four were the top of the hufaz. The top of the hufaz. There was also a lot of knowledge. They knew it. من Abdullah ibn Mas'ud فبدأ به. He started with him. Take the Quran from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Yeah. Number two, Salim, Mawla Abi Hudhaifa. He was Mawla. He was slave of Abu Hudhaifa. And Abu Hudhaifa freed him and was working and serving the house of Abu Hudhaifa. But he was a scholar. He knew the Quran. Wa Mu'adh ibn Jabalin, number three. So Mu'adh was one of the four Hufathis, or greatest Hufath of the companions among the companions. Wa Ubay ibn Ka'b. So Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Salim, Mawla Abi Hudhaifa, Mu'adh ibn Jabal, wa Ubay ibn Ka'b. That's four. So Mu'adh ibn Jabal was one of them. That's number one. The second hadith, ثانيا, صحيح أبي داود عن معاذ بن جبل قال أخذ بيدي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. We'll see this hadith again, inshallah. فقال إني لا أحبك يا معاذ. Oh, معاذ, I love you. يا معاذ, I love you. So the person who Prophet loves him, yeah, that is means that person is very great. Very great. The most loved one to the Prophet was Abu Bakr. And the most loved of his among his wives was Aisha. So the Prophet loves you, yeah, that will be very great. You'll be very lucky person. So he said, Ya Mu'adh, inna uhibbuka ya Mu'adh. Qultu, he says, he replied, Wa ana uhibbuka ya Rasulallah. Oh, Prophet of Allah, I love you too. And the Prophet advised him, قال فلا تتعن تقول. Don't miss to say. في دبر كل صلاة after كل صلاة. ربي أعني على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. That's our hadith today. So Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, because he loves Mu'adh, he gave him that state. He gave him that dua. He gave him that dua. إنه يحبك يا معاذ. ثالثا نمبر 3 عن ابن عباس ان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بعث معاذا الى اليمن برسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سنت معاذ to يمن. معاذ was very young. معاذ was very young. Early 30s or end of 20s. Prophet Azam sent him to Yemen. It doesn't mean, as we say in Tabligh, 3 days, 5 days. He went there and he leave and stay in there and he come back to visit Medina. But he stays in there living. So the stage Prophet Azam was given him. Ud'uhum ila shahadat Allah ilaha illallah wa anni rasulullah. Yeah. First of all, invite them. Call them to accept the Kalimah of Shahada. Nothing else to worship. Nowhere else you can take rulers. Al-Quran wa Sunnah. Everything you want to do, take it from Quran wa Sunnah. Allah ilaha illallah. Wa anni rasulullah. Fainuma da'udhu li dhalika. If they accept the Shahada, fa'alimhum. Teach them. أن الله قد افترض عليهم 5 صلوات في كل يوم وليلة. الله enjoined it on them. Allah make farad on them 5 times salah in 24 hours. So we start from shahada. After shahada, it comes all the ibadat. Coming all the ibadat. And the most important ibadah is a salah. So that is Shahada and Salah will save you. Nothing else will save you. فَإِنْهُمْ أَدَاعُوا لِذَٰلِكَ. If they accept you call and they start your Salah, فَأَعْلِمْهُمْ, teach them. And Allah افترض عليهم, Allah make obligatory for them صَدَقَةً فِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ, zakah, to pay from their wealth. تأخذ من أغنيائهم, to be taken from their wealth people, وترد على فقرائهم, and give it back to the poor people. That is how it is. In any city, in any area, you take the wealth, you take zakah from the wealth people, and you give to the fuqara of that land. You give to the fuqara of that land. After that, if there is something left, you can give to the Amir al-Mu'mineen to distribute to the others. But it doesn't mean there is fuqara next to you in your city, and you take zakah, and you send it all the way to the Amir al-Mu'mineen. That's not. So, وَتُرَدْتُ عَلَىٰ فُقَرَائِهِمْ, give him back to the poor people. رابعاً التعليقات الحسان عن معاذ بن جبل قال لما بعثوا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى اليمن ومبروس العسلم سنتهم تو يمن خرج معه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Prophet came with him, came out with him. You see he advancing him. ومعاذ راكب, معاذ was riding his camel, ورسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم تحت راحلته. And the Prophet was walking under the camel of Mu'adh. Look at the state of the Prophet. Prophet, we should learn manners from the Prophet. Mu'adh is hiding because he's traveling, he's leaving. And Rasulullah walking beside the camel. Mu'adh was able to come down and walk with the Prophet, but Prophet didn't want that. He stayed Mu'adh on the camel. And Prophet was walking. So Prophet was advising him. From ma faragha. When Prophet finished his advice, he said, Ya Mu'adh, innaka asa, maybe it will happen. Allah talqani ba'd aami hadha. You are not going to see me after this year. That means, while you are in Yemen, the Prophet will pass away. While you are in Yemen, the Prophet will pass away. لَعَلَّكَ أَلَّا تَلْقَانِي بَعْدَ عَامِ هَذَا. لَعَلَّكَ, you may be أن تمر when we come back from Yemen, you will pass بمسجدي وقبري. Yeah. My masjid and my grave. So Prophet Salman knew where he was going to die. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the command in the prophets will be buried in the spot they die. And when he was sick, he requested to be in the house of Aisha. And that he knew that was he's going to be his grave. Masjidi wa qabri. So what Mu'adh then? Fabaka Mu'adhun. Khasha'an. Uncontrollable. He cried out of the great respect. Lifiraq Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because he's going to be separated from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Khamisan. An Asad ibn Yazid in Qal. Asad ibn Yazid. He was Yemeni. He lives in Yemen. He said, Atana Ma'ad ibn Jabal bil Yemeni. Ma'ad ibn Jabal came to us in Yemen. Why he came? He came Mu'alliman wa Amiran. Mu'alliman, teaching us the Islam. Wa Amiran, and ruling us according to Quran and Sunnah. Fasa'alnahu, we asked him. An rajulin tuwfiya, a man who has passed away. وترك ابنته وأخته, and he left behind his daughter and his sister. فعد الابنة النصف. It's very important to learn the inheritance. He gave the daughter one half of the property, والأخت النصف, and he gave to her sister other half, and gave the sister other half. The scholars say the daughter will take half, and the sister, combining sister with the daughter, they should take two-thirds. So rest of the two-thirds, which is 160, the sister will take. Others will go to the male in the family, or back to Baitul Mal. But Ma'ad, he said no. He said half to the daughter and half to the sister. Why Ma'ad done that? عن أبي سعيد الخدري قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم معاذ بن جبل أعلم الناس, he's the most knowledgeable person among the people. Among the people, among the companions, and all of the companions, he's the most knowledgeable person. بحلال الله وحرامه, the halal and the haram which Allah commanded us. He's the most knowledgeable. At that age, that he was end of 20s, earlier 30s, yeah, and was the most knowledgeable person. For that reason, what Umar ibn Khattab done? قال عمر بن الخطاب لو استخلفت, if I want to appoint the Khalifa after me, because Abu Bakr Siddiq appointed عمر بن الخطاب to be his Khalifa after his death. So Mu'adh ibn Jabal, Umar ibn Khattab, was looking to the companions, who can be in his position if he dies? Yeah. He said, you should be Abu Ubaid ibn Jarrah. So Umar wants Abu Ubaid ibn Jarrah to be his successor. But Ubaid ibn Jarrah died. When he died, Umar, he put in his mind, Mu'adh ibn Jabal should be his successor. Mu'adh died. So Umar ibn Khattab said, لو استخلفت, if I was appointing someone to be my successor, I was selecting Mu'adh ibn Jabal. So whatever you do, you are accountable on judgment day. فسألني ربي عز وجل, if Allah asks me tomorrow, yeah, ما حملك على ذلك, why you selected Mu'adh to be your successor? What I should say? لقلت سمعت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, I heard your prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم say, إن العلماء, all the scholars, إن is emphasizing, sure, all the scholars of this ummah, إذا حضروا ربهم, when they come in front of the Lord, on the judgment day. All who call scholars, they are coming. When they are coming, Mu'adh should be among them. Kana Mu'adh bayn aydihim. Mu'adh not among them. Yeah, he is leading them in front of them. Yeah. Khatwatan bihajarin. The distance of throwing stone, it is like 50 feet. So Mu'adh bin Jabal is leading the scholars of Ummah. All the scholars, he's in front of them. All the scholars of the mankind, he's in front of them, leading them. That was the knowledge of Mu'adh bin Jabal. This is end of the biography of Mu'adh bin Jabal. سبحان الله وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك وصلى الله وسلم على نبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين.